friends, very good afternoon. This is Kalp Shah from Kalp Shah CA Classes and Agarwal Consultants. Today we are going to see one of the important topic of Foreign Exchange Management Act, and that topic is very much important from practical aspect, not from exam point of view. And the topic name is Resident Foreign Currency Account and Resident Foreign Currency Domestic Account. This topic will be very much useful for my NRI friends or whosoever have come back from foreign, who have lived abroad for many years and who wants to stay in India or come back to India. And this is also useful for my Indian friends who want to keep foreign currency in their bank account. Okay, so regarding foreign currency account, there is a circular or master circular of Reserve Bank of India, Foreign Exchange Management Act notification. Foreign Exchange Management Foreign Currency Accounts by a Person Resident in India Regulation 2015. According to this regulation, we can see in exercise of the powers conferred by Section 9, Clause E or Subsection T 2 of Section 47 of FEMA, and the suppression of this notification as amended from time to time, RBI makes the following regulations. Let's start with the regulation. First of all, there is some definition. Authorized dealer means we are seeing many authorized dealer like money transfer, Western Union, or every bank like State Bank of India, Bank of Baroda, HDFC is an authorized dealer these days. Foreign currency account means an account held or maintained in currency other than currency of India or Nepal or Bhutan. ये ऐसा कोई भी अकाउंट जो इंडिया के रुपीज़ या नेपाल की करेंसी या फॉरेन की सॉरी भूटान की करेंसी के अलावा कोई भी और करेंसी जिस अकाउंट में रहती है उस अकाउंट को फॉरेन करेंसी अकाउंट कहते हैं. जैसे कि डॉलर का जिस अकाउंट में आपके डॉलर पड़े, यूरो पड़े, पाउंड पड़े. शेड्यूल मीन्स शेड्यूल दिस रेगुलेशंस. एंड जनरली इफ़ यू आर सेइंग देयर इज अ रिस्ट्रिक्शन टू होल्ड फॉरेन करेंसी बाय इंडियन रेसिडेंट. इंडियन रेसिडेंट इज अ पर्सन हु हैज स्टेड in India in the last financial year for 183 days or more than 183 days. That is a simple definition of Indian resident, person resident in India. And person resident in India is barred, is prohibited to keep some foreign currency in his account. But this is not some blanket restriction. There are some relief or there are some exceptions to this main rule. And according to this exception, we can keep some money in some foreign currency. And for that, there are types of accounts mentioned by RBI. First account they have mentioned is exchange earned foreign currency account. Second is resident foreign currency account. Third is resident foreign currency domestic account. We have already seen exchange earned foreign currency account in a separate video. But in this video, I will discuss resident foreign currency account. And the rule regarding this says that save as otherwise provided in the act or rules, no person resident in India shall open or hold or maintain a foreign currency account. Generally, it is barred, it is prohibited to open a foreign currency account. But there is some proviso. Provision means in law, wherever there is written provided, that means it is an exception to the main rule. So according to this exception, we can keep this kind of account. First is exchange earned foreign currency account. Second is resident foreign currency account. Let's see what is resident foreign currency account. A person resident in India may open, hold and maintain with an authorized dealer in a foreign currency account to be known as a resident foreign currency account. The Reserve Bank of India has authorized many dealers to deal in foreign currency. Apart from those dealers, you cannot buy or sell foreign currency, or you cannot have account of foreign currency apart from those authorized dealer. And every bank, generally every bank in India or every scheduled commercial bank or every government bank is a authorized dealer for foreign exchange purpose as per Foreign Exchange Management Act and as per RBI. So you need to open an account of foreign currency with a bank, with your local bank, say for example State Bank of India, to be known as, and this account will be called as resident foreign currency account. But to deposit the money in this account, to deposit foreign currency in this account, the source of this money should be below mentioned only. Apart from this source, you cannot deposit money in foreign currency, resident foreign currency account. And these are the sources which they have mentioned. First source is received as pension or any other superannuation, annuation or other monetary benefit from his employer outside India. See, this rule is applicable to a person resident in India. For that, you should be in India for 183 days or more than 183 days in the last financial year. That means you have worked in foreign country and you have now you are coming back to India, and now you are say for example you are enjoying your retirement life, or you are enjoying your after 40s or after 50s life in India. That means you are a person resident in India. You can hold, maintain, or open an account of foreign currency. That is, say for example you were in dollar, for so you were in United States, so you must be having some dollars, so you can keep the those dollars which you have earned over there in abroad. That means when you were abroad, say for example you are Sundar Pichai, the CEO of Google. When Sundar Pichai was residing in USA, while he was residing in USA, he earned salary from Google Inc, and that salary is savings of his work abroad. So that salary can be kept in this foreign currency account. This is the basic example which I have given you for what kind of money you can keep in foreign currency account. That means the sources below mentioned, that is ABCD, only money received from these sources you can keep in foreign currency account. So the money should be earned from these sources. The first source is your received as pension or any other superannuation or other monetary benefit from his employer outside India. When you was in USA, when you were in USA, you earned money from Google Inc. And you are Sundar Pichai, okay? Now you are retiring, you will get pension from Google Inc. So that money you can keep in resident foreign currency account, okay? This is basic example. First money should come from your previous employment abroad. That means pension of previous employment abroad. Second is realize or conversion of the assets referred to in subsection 4 of section 6 of the and repatriated to India. That means you have realized the assets which you have earned when you were outside India. What does this section 6 subsection 4 says us? Here it is, let me open it. Section 6 subsection 4 says us, let's see it. This is section 6 is all about capital account transactions, and capital account transaction they have said that a person resident in India may hold, own, or transfer or invest in foreign currency, foreign security, or any immovable property situated outside India if such currency, such security, such property was acquired or was held or was owned by such person when he was resident outside India or inherited from a person who was resident outside India. That means when you were working over there, you acquired, you hold, and you own those currency or security or immovable property. That means when you were working over there in Google Inc, you were resident over there, because in that year you resided for more than 182 days, and the next year will become in the next year you will become a resident. Say for example you resided for more than 182 days in the year 2012-2013 starts from 1st April 2012 and ends on 31st March 2013. So in that year, financial year 12-13, you reside Google CEO Sundar Pichai resided for more than 182 days. So he will become resident. He will become person resident outside India for the year 13-14, for the financial year 13-14, and whatever income he has earned during financial year 13-14 was acquired, held and owned by him when he was a person resident outside India. That means his foreign earning can be kept in this account, his local earning in India cannot be kept in this account. That means realization, here we will read it again, realized on conversion of these of the assets. Which assets? Which we have written over here. Currency, security or immovable property. Dollar, security or immovable property. You have realized it. That means you have sold those assets and converted, either you have converted into dollars or any other currency. So that all the money have been converted into, or all the properties, be it any shares, be it any immovable property, any intellectual property, you have converted, that means you have sold into, sold and received dollar. Those dollars you can keep in this account, residence, foreign currency account. Next is received or acquired as a gift or inherent from a person referred to in subsection 4 of 6. That means you are son of Mr. Sundar Pichai or you are a brother of Sundar, Mr. Sundar Pichai. Sundar Pichai's son has got all his security, all his immovable property and currency in inheritance from his father, Mr. Sundar Pichai. Say for example, Mr. Sundar Pichai's son name is Ram Pichai. So Ram Pichai has got all the property, all the security and all the currency in inheritance from his father, Mr. Sundar Pichai. And Mr. Sundar Pichai earned those money when he was not resident in India. That means he was person resident outside India in the financial year 13-14. And that money or that currency he has gifted to his sons. And his son can keep this money in his resident foreign currency account. Next is referred to in clause C of section 9 of the act or acquired as gift inherent therefrom. Section 9 clause C says when whatever currency or whatever proper currency you got by selling any immovable property or any securities which you earned or which you received before 8th of July 1947, that means approximately before the independence of India, whatever money you get, you can easily keep that in a residential residence foreign currency account. This is the 9C. Section 9 subsection C says foreign exchange held by a person, acquired or received before 8th day of July 1947 or any income arising or accruing thereon which is held outside India by a person in pursuance of a general or special permission by RBI. And next is received as the proceeds of life insurance policy. Whatever money you have got as a maturity claim or your death claim or surrender value, whatever you have got as a life insurance policy settled in foreign currency, and that claim you should have got in foreign currency. Say for example, you have got that claim in dollars when you were in USA. So that dollars you can keep in this resident foreign currency account from insurance company in India permitted to undertake life insurance business by insurance regulatory and development, and that too that insurance company should be Indian insurance company, and that insurance company should be allowed to insure you or take insurance of your life when you are in abroad. That's it. Next is the fund. These are the sources A, B, C, D from which you can keep money in resident foreign currency account. Next is the funds in a resident foreign currency account open or held maintained in terms of sub-regulation 1. This is sub-regulation 1. We are reading 2. Shall be free from all restriction. Free from all restriction regarding utilization of foreign currency balancing, including any restriction on investment in any form by whatever name called outside India. That means you can use the way you like. There is no restriction. Shall be free from all restriction regarding utilization of foreign currency balance, including restriction on investment in any form by whatever you can invest those money in any security or any property in any corner of the world. Okay? That means there is no restriction regarding utilization and regarding investment of those money which is lying in resident foreign currency account. Next is resident individuals are permitted to include resident relative as their joint holders in their resident foreign currency account or on former or survivor basis. However, such resident Indian relative or joint account holder shall not be eligible to operate the account during the lifetime of the resident account holder. The former or survivor basis itself says that the meaning of former or survivor basis, meaning that say for example there are two joint holders, Mr. A and B. Mr. A is the former and Mr. B is later. So when until the former is alive, say for example Mr. A is husband, Miss B is Mrs. B is his wife. So until Mr. A is alive, her wife cannot operate this resident foreign currency account, even if she is Mrs. B is a joint holder of this resident foreign currency account. Next is, for the purpose of sub-regulation, the expression relative shall be have the same meaning as it mentioned in section 2 subsection 77 of Companies Act. What does the section 2 subsection 77 says? Relative means with reference to any person, means any person who is related to any another person, if they are members of a Hindu undivided family, they are husband and wife, and one person is related to another person in the manner as may be prescribed. As may be prescribed is prescribed in this fashion. A person shall be deemed to be the relative of another person. He or she is related to another person in the following manner. Father is a relative. Your father is your relative. Husband, wife, so already mentioned in the main section. This is regulation or rule. In this rule, they included father as a relative, including stepfather, mother, including stepmother, son, including stepson, son's wife. Next is daughter. Daughter's husband is also included in your relative. Brother, including stepbrother, sister, including stepsister. These are your relative. They can be your joint holder, but they are on former or survivor basis. Until you are alive, they cannot operate the account. Next, this was the first kind of foreign currency account, which is mainly from the persons who were foreigners, who were residing abroad, and now they are coming back to India. Generally, the person of Indian origin go over there. When they retire, they come back to India and they want to live peaceful life in India, or they want to enjoy Indian culture, whatever the reason may be. Next is resident foreign currency domestic account.